Hi, my name's Tristan, and these are the Kawaguchi Lectures. On Sunday the 14th, 2019, I was lucky enough to be present at a series of lectures that Mr. Kawaguchi gave at the Australian leg of the Gundam Builders World Cup. These lectures were unique from the point of view that they've only ever been delivered once in public, and this was in Osaka, Japan, I believe it was earlier this year. They have never been delivered, heard, or viewed in the English-speaking world. With the help of Lincoln Wright, who is the brains and face behind Paint and Plastic and is also a 25-year veteran of the Japanese modelling industry, we are now very lucky to be able to have these lectures. As I said, have never been heard of outside of Japan, and they've only occurred once before. Thanks to Lincoln, we're actually able to get a translation into modeler's language and I'll just gain some insight into the way Mr. Kawaguchi does stuff. We were privileged enough to be able to hear him speak quite passionately about one of his favorite topics, which is using the Gundam story to influence your Gunpla building, alongside getting an insider's point of view of the judging process at the finals of the Gundam Builders World Cup. These lectures are unique from the point of view that at these conventions, he usually just delivers workshop-style demonstrations, which is him showing people how to paint or how to scribe, etc., etc., etc. We don't actually get to hear him talk through a process and show and share the love that he has for this property that he's been involved with since day one. It's now celebrating 40 years. So, you know, he is, as we all know, the face of Gundam, but I don't think a lot of people understand his actual role and involvement in the property. So to be able to actually listen to him talk about this stuff as opposed to showing us how to do things was a very unique experience. Given that these two talks went for well over an hour, I've split them up into their natural breaking points just to allow for easier access for viewing. Because if you're like me, trying to sit down and digest something that's like 60 plus minutes is actually quite difficult. So I've split them up into 4 to 5 parts each at natural break points in the talks, focusing on a specific topic that was in that section of the talk. I do apologize in advance. The noise, sound quality, I've done the best that I can. I am not a sound engineer. I've isolated and boosted the volume and the audio as much as I can. But unfortunately, there is a bit of noise in the background because it is filmed at a convention. In one of the talks, there's like a trumpet playing some anime theme for a couple of minutes, which does get a little bit annoying, but you can still hear the audio quite well. So I do apologize in advance. Remember, I'm not a professional film sound person. I'm just a guy with a camera who's sitting in the front row. Please enjoy these videos. I'm really hoping that they're of help to you. And it was my pleasure to be able to record them and edit them. Again, I do apologize for the sound quality. I've done the best that I can. I'm not a professional. So please enjoy.
そうすると、これはもう僕の勝手なイメージね。じゃあここでの作られた、108のガンキャノンと、ここでハヤトが乗った109のガンキャノンって、もしかしたらマイナーチェンジされてるかもしれない。
ですよね。はい。So Kawaguchi-san's got the cool idea that because 108 had been through this process, obviously they would learn things. It's cool to imagine that the 109 that was built partway through after encountering Jabiro there in South America, we could expect that some minor changes and upgrades could have happened.
で、特に108の方っていうのはガンダムもそうなんだけど、ここテストされた段階だから、それが本当に量産された時はまた多分違ってるんじゃないかなと思うわけ。
So we could also imagine because 108 Kai's gun cannon,when it was sent to Side 7, it was a prototype, it was a test. So we could also assume that more changes would happen quickly due to it being a prototype.
で、そうすれば、本当にもうナンバーだけ変えても全然いいと思うんだけど、もうちょっとなんかやっぱいろいろ変えてみたいなと思う、やっぱ模型の好きな人はちょっと考えちゃうわけです。
So of course there are some changes that can be made, but Kawaguchi-san himself particularly likes making these adjustments and improvements. So he spent a bit of time thinking about this.
で、一番簡単なのは、
okay.
ガンキャノンの HG って2種類あるんですよ。
Okay, so the first thing, the easiest one is that there happens to be two kinds of kits for the gun cannon.
で、HG がシリーズ始まった頃に、作られたプロダクツっていうのがこれなんですけど。
Okay, so the first gun cannon that was made for the HG series is this one, one of the older kids.
で、最近作られた、リニューアルされたガンキャノンがこちら。
And then quite recently, this one has been made.
で、なんでこっちに108でこっちに109にするかというと、最初の頃のプロダクツを、じゃあ例えばそのテストタイプで勝手に考えれば、109はここで、
So Kawaguchi-san, he personally enjoys the idea that, of course, then the old kit must obviously represent the original 108 version, and then due to the developments, the 109 was the one issued to Hayato here in Jaburo.
だからそういうストーリーが分かってると、モデルキットを一つ手に取っても。どういうふうに作ろうかっていうイメージを広げていくことができるわけ。
And that's the fun part. By knowing the story, that added enjoyment to Kawaguchi-san's idea of using the two kits. It's not just the gun cannon. He gets to make a story about them.
で、ただそれだけだとね、あまりにもなんか
足りないですよね。
ちょっと楽しくないじゃない
？So, but that's not enough, is it? That's pretty obvious.And for Kawaguchi-san, that's not enough fun.
で、今ちょっと出してるのが、この HG の最近のガンキャノン使って作ったモデルになります。
So, the base kit for this is the recent edition of the Gun Cannon Tank. Gun Cannon Kit, excuse me.
今これ、108のナンバー入れてます。
108 version 作りました。And with that new kit,Kawaguchi-san has gone back and made a 108, a Kai version.
で、まあ今この赤、ちょっともう最初のサイド7からずっと戦ってきてるから、ちょっと汚れてたりとか、それからまあダメージは今回入れてないんですけど、ちょっとライフルの色が変わってたりとかっていうアレンジを入れてます。
だから even though it's the new kit,Kawaguchi-san has decided too, because it's 108 and he's gone through quite an epic story, he has the plan now to add more damage and weathering to this guy.
で、109を同じキットで作ろうと思った時に、まあ、こっから宇宙に出てるわけだから、はい、新品ですよ、多分。
So another fun thing to think about is because this one has had some career of action, that's why it can be more damaged. But then, when we're making the Hayato version from Jaburo, of course, making a factory fresh version could be really cool for him. Oh, shiny!
それをイメージして、作ったのはこっちの109ね。
So that was exactly Kawaguchi-san's image for this guy, a brand new factory fresh, recently issued 109.
で、今赤の色はもうちょっと違うじゃないですか。
いいね。
で、宇宙の、はい工場で作られたカラーと、はい、地球で作られたカラーって多分違うこともあるかな、はいはいはい、と思うわけ。
Another cool thing to think about could be that because one's made on Earth and one was made in a space factory, the colors, of course, could be different.
で、特にあの108の方もずっと戦ってきてるから途中で色塗られたりとか、傷がついてるところなんかもこう直されたりとかしてるから、多分いろんな人の手がかかってできてるんで、ちょっと、アンダーな 色合いで仕上げてます。
はい。はいSo, Kawaguchi-san also gave this one some thought to it also being refurbished after that battle, like periodic maintenance. So that's part of the finish he was thinking of as well for this one.
で、今、その色だけでも、それだけ表現で変えられるわけですよね。で、ダメージのあり、ついてる、ついてないだけでも、こっからとこっからで今、この辺に入り寄った時には違いがやっぱり表現できるわけ。
So that's an interesting way we can think about it. By just varying the colors, the finish, and the amount of apparent damage they had, we can do make a narrative, a story, the concept of following their timeline and journey.
だから そういうことをちょっと考えていくと、じゃあ、この時の何は、モビルスーツはどういう状態だっただろうとか、宇宙で戦ってるのと地上で戦ってるんだと汚れ方が違うんじゃないかとか、そういうちょっと表現をしていく時の、イメージっていうのをいろいろ自分で選ぶことができる。
So Kawaguchi-san says it's fun because you can use that story to choose places along the timeline there to add a different finish and expression, and it's fun to do.
で、それで塗装をしてるんですが、もう一つ、もうちょっとなんか、違いを出せないかなと思った時に、
Now, when he was painting them, he thought, I need to make it somehow a little bit more different somehow.
モビルスーツを運転するのって多分大変だと思うんですよ。
He believes that driving a mobile suit, piloting a mobile suit, in Japanese they use the verb for driving, that it must actually be quite difficult to do.
それまで、ガンタンクに乗ってたハヤトは、まあ、ここまでは日本足で歩くのに乗ってないわけですよ。
はい。
まあ、時々乗ったりもするけどね。メインで動かしてたのはこっちだから、
はい、
基本的にはじゃあ新しいモビルスーツをもらったらまずそれに慣れなきゃならないわけですよね。
So if we go back and take into account the original television version of the story, Hayato-san wasn't used to driving, piloting a two-legged mecha. He was driving around in this thing. So we've got to imagine he had kind of newbie skills with upgrading to a two-legged mecha.
で、本当の軍人さんだったらそういう訓練も受けると思うけども、ガンダムに出てくるあのパイロットたちってみんな普通の人たちだから訓練受けてないはずなんですよ。
So if they were professionals from the military, you could imagine they would have had a lot of training, but、as you guys know, the Gundam pilots are kind of just regular people, right? So...
こうずっと戦っていくうちにそれがもう訓練と同じように実践で覚えてたわけね。
But of course they were trained on the field of battle because they went through all of this process. We could say that they were highly trained at the end of it.
じゃあ自分がジャブローの司令官で、
So thinking of myself as ジャブロ
ー、ガンタンクの代わりにハヤトにガンキャノン乗れっていうふうに命令を出すときに何を考えるか。
So putting himself in the situation of the commander sending Hayato into battle on this, he tried to think what would be behind his motivations of making that order.
まあこれが飛んでるのを考えればとても機動性も悪そうだし本当に撃てるのって思うし、
So he could imagine that if he was given this as one of his units to be giving orders to, he would be thinking, really? That thing can fly? That thing can fight?
であれば、ガンキャノンだったら、宇宙空間だったら歩かなくても多分そんなには問題ないだろうから、とりあえずこっちで行ってもらった方がいいかなって思うかなって。
And if he was the commander, he would imagine, well, we don't need this driving in space.I would just send out the two-legged mecha units and just go, go on, get on with it.
で、まあ一人でどっちにしても、まあガンタンクも後半は今一人で全部オペレーションするんだけども、まあ一人でオペレーションする機体ということで、なるべくこっちに早く慣れてもらえる。で、戦力になってもらわないと意味がないので、そしたら、見てもらうと分かると思うんだけど、大砲が違うんですよ。ちょっとどうしようかな。こっちに置いてもらった方がいい？
They want me to look at it. Sorry, guys. もうピカピカであんまり経験がなさそう。ただ宇宙で飛んでる感じがする。
これからいろいろ戦う状態ね。で、108と109を、まあ、ここから見てもらうと対応は違うでしょ。
そう、全然長さとかが違う。So, sorry, Mark, the customization.
なのでね、ぜひですね、まあ、別にそれコンテストだけに限らず、普段皆さん作るときにね、
どういうふうに仕上げにしようかなっていうのを最初にやっぱり考えてもらうと、こういうじゃあここはこうしよう、ここはどうしようっていうアイデアが多分いろいろ出てくると思います。
So this is not talking in particular with a competition. This is more about, you know, when we're making our own models to make sure that we enjoy a bit more freedom with them.
なんでね、多分、スケールモデル作られる方は、最初にじゃあどこの、まあ、車でもいいや、じゃあ F1 マシンで、どこのレースの車体にしようかっていうのを最初に決めないと、ナンバーもそうだし、
そうですよね、
マーキングも変わってきちゃいますよね。
So for example, taking what happens in another genre, just say you're a scale modeler who also makes F1 cars.Actually, before you start, you have to choose where that car raced because it will completely change how it looks.
それと同じで、最初に自分はこういうものを作りたいんだっていうふうに決めておけば、じゃあ、どの色を使おう、どういった改造をしよう、どういったディテールアップをしようっていうプランが自分で作れると思うんですよ。
So in a very similar way, actually, when we're making Gunpla, if we decide where, when, what was happening, where it is in its timeline, that can actually help and give us guidance on how to finish the model.
だからそういうの面倒くさいと思うか、面白いと思うか、まあ多分人によって違うと思うんだけど。
Now, depending on the person, that could be a bit of a pain in the...You know what? Or that could be a great source of joy and entertainment. That's up to you.
僕どっちかというとそういうの面白がっちゃうんで、40年やめずに来ちゃいましたけど。
So, but for Kawaguchi-san, he's been doing that for 40 years, and he personally really enjoys that aspect of it.
なのでね、多分、例えば改造しようっていうふうに思った時に、いろんなやり方多分皆さんもよく。普段からやってらっしゃる方もいると思うんですよ。
And of course, and any number of, a great number of you are also doing this kind of thing, making your modifications and changes to your models.
で、普段ね、実際作るときに使ってるスキルやなんかを使えば、そういうことできちゃうわけ。
So, of course, when you're making your own stuff, when it's for you and your own enjoyment, just please go ahead and do what you want.
で、今、まあ、さっきね、言葉で言ったけどこれがガンタンクの
So of course this is the large cannon from the gun tank
で、これがガンキャノン今、108と同じ
Right, and that's from the 108?
で、今、その109で作ってるのはこれでここでカットしてで、この先端のキャップをつけた状態です、
And as you can see, this was the modification in the middleWhere Kawaguchi-san has cut in here, taken the cap off here, and melded them together.
で、そうすると多分ハヤト君は、うまく攻撃できるんじゃないかなと思うわけですよ。
So he believes that's what Hayato-san would have done.
で、今これそのままだとね、入んないのね、サイズが。
But the actual size of this is not compatible with the model. It's too big.
なので、一旦ここのガイドカットして
Wow, so you had to modify it right down.
で、まあ、付け直すんですけども、まあ、そのまま付けると結構はみ出してる
みたいな。So if you put it on as is, quite a bit hangs over the edge and doesn't look quite right.
で、その、最後、この周りのカバーね。これもプラ板で。
Wow! So, to fix that, Kawaguchi-san decided to make scratch-build extra covers to accommodate the larger weapon.
で、これを最後仕上げて、まあ、両肩同じように。
And once it's put together like this, it looks in form, in principle, very close to the original.
で、最終的に仕上げたものは、まあ、こういう形になるわけです。
And once we paint it up,Looks like this.
そうだね。はい。なので、今ここでそのガンキャノンで、改造したのはこの肩のとこと、それからあと背中、さっきの背中のね、バックパックのところの、ピン。
あ、あれもプラ板で作りましたね。
そうですそうです。
おお、cool. So again, the
Okay.
Can you see? the backpack was also modified in a similar way with styrene sheet to put in the heating vanes, the cooling vanes on the back here.
ここのところが、まあ、元のね、ランドセルを一部カットしてで、カットしたところにこうプラバンを入れている状態です。
So it sounded like you made primary cuts into the backpack tank area there to open this up.
その時にもう一回例えば、最初の頃のね、ガンキャノンだとやっぱディテールが違ったりもするし、そういったものを入れていっても面白いと思います。
And just by making these changes here, you can see that these side verniers, I guess they are on the side vents, also add a very different look.
でガンプラの場合結構時々そういう、メインモビルスーツってリニューアルされるものが多いんで、まあ、古くなったもの、まあ、もう新しい方が作りやすかったりもするんだけどね、デザイン的にこっちの方が好きっていう人も結構いたりします、古い方が。
So you could imagine as they're making newer models, they'd have less resources given over to them, so they might leave older details on the older existing suits.
だそこの部分だけじゃその昔の、古いパーツを持ってくるだとかっていうのもガンプラの場合はできると思うんですよ。
So what Kawaguchi-san did was he took the older style parts from the older kit and transferred it over to the new one.
まあガンプラの場合って、まあ、古いキットでもね、まあ、いつも生産してるわけではないけども、まあ、何年かに1回ぐらいは販売してるんで、うんでそういう機械に好きなモビルスーツがもしあれば、それは手に入れておいた方がいいかもしれない。
So, I'm really sorry guys, with the echo and the reverb, it's cancelling out a lot of words. I can hear about half sometimes, so this is brutal. It's not just the volume thing, it's the echo. But going through the back catalogue, there's a lot of really old, cool kits that we can use for, you know, scavenging these kinds of details and parts from.
まあ、こういう感じで、まあ、最初のタイトルで、まあ、ストーリーすると面白くなるよ、まあ、本当に面白いと思えるかどうかは、まあ、皆さんの気持ちだからわからないけど。
So Kawaguchi-san, you can really feel, unusually, a lot of you put your hands up to say you know the story, and you could tell by your faces that you really, you know, you enjoy it as well. But that is another aspect to the Gunpla hobby that we can enjoy.
で特にデュオラマなんか作られる方っていうのはそういうストーリーを、イメージするとより、シーンっていうのを表現しやすくなると思うんでね。
And that's a really fun thing to do too when you're making the diorama to use it, make it a scene out of the story.
なのでそういろんなガンプラの作り方ってあると思うんだけれども、それをうまく使い分けて自分が作りたいものを作るっていうのが、いいと思います。
So that's a really fun thing to do too, that you can change the, actually the way you're making your Gunpla too, which makes it fun as well, making a different theme.